I'll be making a presentation on standardization and quality in cosmetics. I will just touch upon the areas which BI is associated with these cosmetics products, and our expert will enlighten us for the globally what are the areas in which work is being done. So I will start with this. When we think about cosmetics, the first thing which comes into the mind is women applying decorative cosmetics. Whereas the fact is that cosmetics include a wide range of products which are being used in our daily life, irrespective of gender. this cosmetic definition, it has been taken from the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. And it says that any article intended to be rubbed, poured, sprinkled or sprayed or introduced into or otherwise applied to the human body or any part thereof, cleansing, beautifying, promoting attractiveness or altering the appearance, and includes any article intended for use as a component of cosmetics. So when we look at this slide, we can see that variety of products, cosmetics are being used by us. You can see that hair oils, gels, toothpaste, tooth powder, mouthwashes, shampoos and conditioners, perfumes, deodorants, soaps and hair colors. Next. Then the question arises, why standards are needed for cosmetics? So the safety of cosmetics is of prime importance, as we all know, as only safe cosmetics products should be used. We all are aware that different types of cosmetics, chemicals, colorants, preservative, etc. are used for the manufacture of cosmetics. Nowadays, generally concerns are being raised about the safety aspect requirements which can be achieved. This can only be achieved through the standardization. And then another is performance requirement for the products related to cosmetics. This it should basically the intended use of the cosmetic product should also be met, for which performance requirements are needed to be addressed through these standards. For example, we can say that when we are doing paving test or breaking load test, say in the case of lipstick, so it should not break, and there should be a proper application of the lipstick also. In shampoo, if you take, then it should perform well, it should have a foaming capacity. And then suppose if you take example of bindi, then it should have a proper drying time also. Then comes the standard must address the good manufacturing practices. They should also address this good manufacturing practices. Basically, what we can say is that hygienic areas, which should be while preparation of manufacture of this cosmetics, that should be taken care of. And next important is product labeling requirement. This is very essential for all the cosmetics, since when we buy a cosmetic product, generally we tend to see whether any safety requirement has been specified or any caution or any warning requirements are there. And then there are some general disclosures to customers also that how this cosmetic should be used and what care is required to be used for this. When we talk about the product labeling requirement, we can say that there are some essential labelings which should be addressed. For example, when we say that there may be people who may be sensitive to some chemicals used in the cosmetics, or they may be allergic to some chemicals which have been used in the manufacture of cosmetics, which must be indicating through the labeling. When we talk about this safety requirements, this is of prime importance, I have already said. There is awareness has grown among both among the manufacturers as well as the regulators as well as the health authorities of the hazards involved in the using of cosmetics. To serve the intended purpose of safeguarding the interests of the consumer, as well as simultaneously leaving enough scope for innovative formulation, BIS has formulated standards for requirements for cosmetics ingredients, raw materials, as well as safe evaluation of cosmetics. For cosmetic ingredients, raw material, when we talk about it, basically there are two standards, 47071 part 1 as well as part 2. part one is basically a classification of cosmetic raw material and adjuncts. That is basically it is for colorants only. What type of colors are permitted in this? This colorants which are generally recognized as safe. The terminology what I have used, we have used earlier is GRAS. That specifies that those are use safe for use. And field of application is also defined. That is, for example, it should not, some chemicals are used in some cosmetics, so vicinity of eyes and mucous membrane, etc., that should be taken care of. Skin allergy, that has to be taken care of this when these cosmetic ingredients, raw materials are used. As far as the part 2 standard is concerned, this is a raw materials which are not recognized, that is GNRAS, that has been considered not safe for use in cosmetics. Some of the example I can give is trichloroacetic acid, allyl isocyanate, thiocyanate, aniline, and as well as the antibiotics also. And then there is raw material for which Indian standard exists shall conform to those relevant Indian standard wherever they are existing. Both the Indian standards are broadly based on EU regulations 1223, 2009. So 4701, part 1, part 2 both. Then comes this safety evaluation of cosmetics. For safety evaluation of cosmetics, BIS formulated this IS 4011, that is method for test for safety of cosmetics. The revised version is presently under print. This standard is referred in finished products specification, about 30 products which we have said that for the finished product. As per the standards, products containing novel ingredients, there may be not standard, but which do not have safety data base required safety testing as prescribed on it. That means it has to be tested for that also. And this standard also gives provides guidelines for skin irritation testing, the for cosmetic, for assessing contact hypersensitivity as well as photosensitization. Then inclusion exclusion criteria for to be followed has also been specified for conducting skin sensitization test in human volunteers. Earlier there was a provision of animal testing for this test methods, but now that has been deleted. Then microbial control is prime importance as far as the cosmetics are concerned. So that requirement is already there in I-14648. That gives the details of the microbiological examination for cosmetics as well as its raw materials. Then we have got heavy materials. So heavy materials is basically lead, mercury, cadmium, arsenic, and then that limit has also been prescribed in that 20 ppm as well as the 2 ppm respectively. For the bio burden of non-objectionable microorganisms beyond a specific limit or presence of pathogenic microorganisms in cosmetic preparation pose health hazards, so that's why microbial controls are being specified. Then for heavy metals, there are it can be through so many raw materials which are used in this cosmetics, that because pigment is also being used, and then other raw material also they may have some toxicological metals. So then there are some of the technical toxicological concern in cosmetics are for this arsenic, lead, cadmium, mercury, and antimony. Then as I already told you, that specified limit has been given for that. For mercury, except thermosol and phenyl mercuric salts, lead, arsenic, cadmium and their compound must not form part of the composition of cosmetic products. In finished product, unintentional mercury, wherever it is being used, it shall not exceed 1 ppm. As far as children are concerned, specifically below 3 years, so number of cosmetic products are used on children, for example, baby skin cream or lotion, powder, hair shampoos, and toothpaste, etc. So such cosmetics must be safe, especially considering that young children are often more sensitive to certain toxic effects, and these are the standards which have been specified, the 4707 part 2, that pays special attention to protecting the health of the infants by limiting, restricting use of certain raw material ingredients and under 3 years of age. So for infant, this skin powder for infant, it shall be free from coloring material, boric acid, and it should be pH controlled also. And we have also this standard on hair shampoo for babies that is under print. Now comes the important part is the labeling requirement. As I've already told that labeling requirement of prime importance for the consumer, firstly they should be able to identify what through the labels. Then we have got two important things on that, that is product specific labeling and caution warning requirement is also there. So these are the general requirements for labeling requirement which must be given in all the cosmetics. And you can see that general name of the material, manufacturer name, etc., net mass, volume, batch number, etc., instruction for use. Then we have two standards, 4701 part 1 and part 2 for GRS and GNRS. That also we have provided to the SARSO Secretariat for taking up suitably. Then in India we have got certain regulation as far as the cosmetics are concerned. Then it comes under the Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1945 and Rules 1945. Schedule S basically covers 36 Indian standards for cosmetics and soaps required to conform to these standards. Out of these 36, 30 standards pertains to PCD, Cosmetics Sectional Committee, and 6 are from Chemical Department. Then there is a requirement in itself, it has been mentioned in the cosmetics rules 1945, that it says that no cosmetic shall contain dyes, colors and pigments other than those specified IS 470 part 1 and schedule Q. Then import and registration of cosmetic is covered under also covered under these rules, and as per which that they are the products cosmetic which are not included under the schedule S, they shall meet with specification under the rules and standards applicable to the country of the origin. And then labeling requirement also, there's 148, rule number 148, it says that both it should be complied for by both domestic as well as the cosmetic products. Then there are many other restrictions provision for use of ingredients, impurities, heavy metals in cosmetics, and are that will be stated in our this, drugs rules and drugs and cosmetic rules, which it can be referred by them also.